C on the opening opposition, pick A to D on the closing government, and type D on the closing opposition. Congratulations for having proceeded to the quarterfinals of the this event. Without any further, the motion before this House is as feminist, this House of Commons is feminist. Without any further ado, I'd like to welcome the Prime Minister to the New York Age Global Settlement here.
Thank you, Chairperson. So, as international says that these women are so extremely feminist, and they for example, they do demonstration on top press in even conservative areas. So, however, we as a member of feminists should be accepted by many citizens as long as possible, and we want we want to protect the women's rights as much as possible. So, to achieve these goals, we should oppose this motion. Okay, so in my speech, I have made three arguments here. First is what's the feminist goal, and second is how these women are promote the people's stigmatized towards feminism, and thirdly, I want to talk about without opposing. Help these women give the bad influence towards the female movement. Okay, so before moving on to my first argument, I wanna set this model. Firstly, the first is about context. We believe this context is like the preceding second wave about feminist, or also yet achieve the second wave, which means the right of women are legally, partially legally accepted. However, the socially their right will be not accepted. For example, the women CEO is so rare case, or also so many people have anxious discrimination or misogynistic norms towards the women. For example, women should be in a home or so forth. And also there are some conservative people living in the society, because in the information society, these women are resist to religion or dictatorship is so conservative towards feminists. That is our model. Okay, so let's go on to first argument. What's feminist goal? So as feminists, we want to protect the women's right as much as possible, and we set the goal without any discrimination, to some extent discrimination towards the women. And so concerning this principle, we most prioritize the women who are so suffering from the misogynistic norms. For example, they cannot even go outside without consent. The husband or spouse, or they cannot work as well as men or spouse. So that we have to be accepted by many people as much as possible, especially mom or conservative people, because without their acceptance, their movement will not proceed. So, okay, and secondly, how these female promote these stigma, people stigmatized towards feminism. Okay, no thank you. So, in the first place, what the women do? For example, as I said in the introduction, they resist to many dictatorships or religion on with a so extreme way or extreme measure. For example, do demonstration on topless or so forth. So it is obvious that this action looks so radical for many people. And looking at this site, so many characters react to the appearance badly. I set two characters. First is so conservative people living in the country, and second is other people who do not know where about the feminism movement. So I'm gonna talk about one by one about the characters. First is the conservative people. No, thank you. Conservative people. They obviously feel that these activities so radical and totally and never accept their movement, because these conservative people think that the women resist to our identity or our dogma rights, of course. So it is obvious that the conservative people never wouldn't accept their activities. And also other people feel that these activities are so different from our view or our thoughts. So they feel strange toward the women. So many people lose incentive to support the feminism movement itself. And at last, the women who are continue to suffering from many these misogynistic norms are continue to suffering from suffer. Yes.
So without these measures that Pan-Pemen takes, how are you going to bring change under your side of the house?
Okay, so that will be answered by my next partner. Okay, so it's finally I'm gonna talk about why we without opposing how women's movement how the women give the bad influence to the feminist movement instead. First of all, in this debate, we are targeting the people who do not. First is the conservative people, and second is more important. Second is the people who do not know and do not have incentive to know about the feminism movement actively. So they think that these activities or this organization is a representation of the feminist movement itself. So they feel that as a whole of feminism, they are so strange, and they are so different from us. So they are more and more conservative, and at last the feminism movement goal itself will be not achieved. That's why we strongly oppose this motion. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Prime Minister, for your remark. Next, I'd like to call on the leader of the opposition to open your case for the 7 minutes here.
that we believe that as a feminist movement, it is important to liberate, of course it is important to liberate this woman, but in this case, we think that it is especially important because as feminists, the most important thing that they have to pursue is to actually, like, is to protect the most vulnerable people living in these areas and living in these areas in the context which is especially in a very, like, exploitive area towards these women. And we say that in these cases, we think that this feminist movement is a uniquely important and necessary thing that the feminist movement should not oppose to. And also, even if it was not again in this kind of context, we say that this movement should exist as a choice and should exist as a choice that the feminist movement should support. So we are proud to oppose. I'd like to talk about two things in my speech. Firstly, I'd like to clarify the context and where this kind of feminist movement is important. I'd like to widen the context that the government side told us. And secondly, I'd like to talk about the outcomes and the harms when the feminist movement opposes to this feminist movement. But before that, a couple of rebuttals to their arguments. So firstly, they talked about how the whole harm was that people are going to feel strange and like it's going to lose the incentive to support this feminist movement. But firstly, we think that it's like contradicting from their own context, because they have already been saying that like this is a context where it's a very conservative area and where these women are very suffering from these kinds of exploitations. In that case, there is already no kind of support in the status quo that they want to seek. So it's not going to like lose the incentive, but in the first place, we want to say that this is the only way to actually achieve any kind of support in the first place. But secondly, we say that just because like from feeling strange or something, it's not going to like it's not going to undermine everyone's like incentive to not support it. But furthermore, we do not understand under their side how they are going to create any kind of changes. That is to say, actually, in the context that they talked about, how these feminist movements are going to what they are going to propose and how they are going to create any changes within their society, we do not see any benefit on their side of the house. So all other rebuttals will be integrated in my speech. Firstly, I'd like to clarify the context and widen the spectrum that the OG talked about. So we think that this, as we have already told you, this feminist movement is necessary and is basically placed in a like a very radical context where these women are especially suffering in this very undeveloped area where this comes necessary, right? So in this kind of undeveloped area, what is exactly happening is so this feminist movement becomes popular in these kind of contexts where, like, for example, it is different from the West in the cases as, like, in the West, like, for example, when Emma Watson says something and, says something to support the feminist movement, like, it can gain attention and it can gain support and it can gain supporters. But that is because that kind of feminist movement is, like, already prominent to some extent, and to some extent people understand that, like, people are already standing up to promote and to protect these women's rights. However, in the context that we are talking about today, it's a much more further undeveloped area, which is to say, like, for example, in countries like Ukraine or in countries like in that kind of like Eastern Europe or those kind of countries where like sexual exploitation is actually like further happening much more. Like, for example, people are like used for sex slaves, or sex tourism and those kind of things. This is very prominent and those kind of areas. And like, for example, in the cases of domestic violence, people cannot voice out, unlike countries like the US, where like society can make some kind of changes by this like social movement. But it's very different in that cases, because in those kind of contexts, like already there is no notion to protect these kind of women in any way. So that means like, for example, these people who did domestic violence are not punished properly or those kind of things. But in that kind of context, no thank you. We think that it's very important for these feminist movement to actually ignite the fact that these women are in the same position and that these women actually deserve to actually be promoted and deserve the rights to actually be like truly free and not just in the like not just at this like second stage. But moving on to my second argument, what is exactly the harms when the feminist opposes to this kind of in this context? Yes.
When women riot religious minorities, they further marginalize religious minorities from that community even more. Concerned the feminist movement is also for other kinds of minorities, how can the feminist movement support these kinds of people?
Okay, but sorry, I'm going to explain that in this argument, right? So how actually the feminist movement should actually support instead of continuing this like oppressive state. So when the feminist actually opposes this, which we think is going to be rather counterproductive, because first in the first place, like women, firstly, in the women living in that kind of like unfair situation is going to feel excluded, right? Because from the women's perception, they are living in such an extreme state in the first place. So they think that like it's fair enough for them to be countered, and it's fair enough for that situation to be countered by that kind of extreme and radical movement. But however, when the feminist movement itself opposes to this kind of feminine movement, these people are going to think that they are not, these people are not going to feel protected, right? These people are going to feel that they are neglected and they are like just neglected from the fact that they deserve the right to be liberated. So in that cases, we think that these feminist women cannot achieve the consequences that they want, right? Because the consequences that the goal is to actually like change the mindset and realize the importance and like ignite the discourse within that area. But more importantly, we think that this is especially the feminist women should support this because by doing so, when, for example, in that context, like the male does something like sexual exploitation to that woman, the media will like pick up that situation, and people will be able to gather like attention to that situation in that unfair situation. So this means that like even in this cases, like there's going to be much more international attention, and there's going to be much more like external kind of movements to actually support these women in that cases. So we think that it should exist. This kind of movement should exist as a choice because the reason why this is important is because like the feminist movement, it should value the like incentive for these women to actually make a change within the society and make a change to promote these women's rights. So we think that this is to protect the most vulnerable people, and this kind of radical attention is necessary. So we are proud to oppose.
Next, I'd like to call on the Deputy Prime Minister to expand your case for the sentence here.
That their side of the house is a truth, like the people are suffering from the sexual reasons or those kind of very conservative areas, we think that if the feminists do the so radical action like topless demonstrations or those kind of things will done in those conservative areas, we think that this discourse step doesn't go to the better directions for the females. So we think it is, that's why we think we should oppose, and feminists should oppose the feminists. Today I have two things to talk about. Firstly, three things to talk about. Firstly, I want to further explain my partners and explanations why like people who have by seeing the famous actions like topless demonstrations, people who live in the conservative area have antipathy, and why it is not better for the females, and it doesn't lead to the females' protections. And also secondly, how in the paradigms comparatively better situation will occur. Like we think that feminists will start negotiating with the men or ask men to get the life for them. And it is better way for them to get the right in the conservative areas. And also surveys about comparisons, because like they talked about that by seeing the females, like people start to start to be interested in the feminist movements and these various things. But we think we want to compare those characters, which character is majorities. We think, of course, because and the characters who think female antithesis or who thinks that the female is a very strange or funny or unpleasant situation organizations, the people who thinks like that is the majorities. So before moving on to my arguments, let me leave out to the opposition sides. So firstly, all the battles I included in my speech. So firstly, about her explanations of my partners. So we think like, of course, like, as my partners are female will be so radical actions and like topless demonstrations. In those situations, how people will act, of course, like the conservative people, especially the men, might think like, oh, they are completely against us because or strengthen that. They strengthen the antipathy or discriminations. Why, of course, like many things that we say, female should be chastity or modesty, or female should be in the homes or should not go out by showing the skins. But they are doing demonstration with the topless. It is a challenge for them. It is there that so because like that, the conservative people, especially men, think like, oh, female. Organizations are consistently or completely against us, and they think like that. So we think, and of course, like as my partner said before, if the people think that feminist movements are all feminist movements are like humans, like they start against the feminist arguments, all feminist actions, and it leads to the much worse situations. Like of course, like if the feminist movement want to. Take address in the public, like they will start like the punish it or stop it, or like people, even if feminist women want to spread their ideas, those people want to stop themselves, stop those actions, and it is harmful. And also like even if there are some people who are not so who don't have so conservative like ideas or like don't discriminate so much, but don't agree with the feminist movement themselves or don't know about the feminist movements. So they think like by seeing the women's actions, like they think like their action is funny or fearful or unpleasant because it is unusual for them to go out to society with the topless or so. So they think like the feminist movement or female is different from us. Or even if they don't discriminate before, they start to discriminate because like people naturally think like the existence which are different from us. If there are people who are different from us, they want to take apart from them. So we think that they start to take apart from them, where even if like in our program there's a possibility to make donation to the feminist movement, they don't do the donations forever. Well, like vote to policy that feminists don't vote to the no thank you, don't vote to the policy that feminist movement are supporting. Or those kind of things occurs. What happens? Of course, like the donation will stop, or don't vote to the policy that feminist is supporting, like the election rights or other like affirmative action for the females. If they don't start to vote, don't start to vote those kind of things, like of course female will suffer in new paradigms, like forced to continue to sexualism or cannot get the elections right, or like cannot become their dreams, or like cannot start to work, or those kind of things occurs. Of course that we want to, the feminists want to oppose. So we think like it is so harmful for in their paradigms. So let's move to my second point before that. Yes,
most people in those conservative areas are already against these women getting rights. How can you achieve this, like, you know, these your changes?
So this is my second argument. So firstly, how many paradigms like comparatively unpleasantly don't go to the old feminist movements and can comparatively achieve our goals? So first, by opposing, what is the meaning of the opposing? Like make the comparing a context that we are opposing to the females. Female is not our colleagues. It is not our members saying like this. So like that create comes from the conservative areas. Like we see so radical, funny, fearful feminists. Why you are doing so much? Or if they are complaining, it's come to the feminist movements. They completely reject to the females. Or female is not our members are saying like that. So by doing like that, of course, like that to some extent, like the sympathies or less than antipathy will occur with the conservative people or not people who don't agree to the feminist movement but don't discriminate, or all those kind of actors. To some extent, in my paradigm, they start to have the sympathy or all those kind of things. So this, it will occur, while others, like of course, as a feminist, many feminists are doing the like negotiation with men or ask men to get in the rights for themselves. It is the main action of that feminist movements are taken. So like one, so like could you, female want to marry man will they lack, and your decision to making marry with the decision by the father, if, even if this is true, like please give the chance to us, or those kind of like very downsides requested is occurred. So we think that by doing that, like comparatively in our paradigms, people don't have the antipathies, and with goals like there is less antipathies, like our work will be more achieved. That's why we think we should propose. Thank you.
Next, I'd like to call on the leader of the citizens to close the front half of this debate. This is here.
These situations of women living in conservative areas to be better. Then the question comes down to which side is better for these women, right? Because the opening government said that these negotiations would work, some people would try to still want to support these feminist movements. But you have to recognize, like in the status quo, that in the highly conservative areas, those people already have vested interests for not, you know, making those women get those rights. We say like it's highly doubtful when the opening government claims that no, these people are likely to, you know, actually change with other feminist movements. We say no, when people are already misogynistic, when that misogyny is highly internalized within that situation, we say it's really unlikely that these changes through negotiations, through support, through donations would occur. Rather, as female, who is actually internationally spotlighted in the media, who actually can actually bring some changes from outside, we say it's something that can bring change, and we say that's something that feminists should be supporting, and that's why we're very proud to oppose it. So based on these two arguments that I'm going to tell you today, first of all, what kind of benefits and harms in like a large scale can we expect under both paradigms? This is going to be the direct cost to the opening government. Second of all, like what, like how would women living in those areas feel when the feminist movement opposes women, and how that's against the goal of the feminist movement? And all my battles will be integrated. So first of all, what kind of benefits and harms you can expect under both paradigms, right? But so they said that, you know, because people are like, you know, these people, mostly conservative people, would actually, you know, do these discriminations, would exploit women even more. But you have to recognize that's the status quo in the first place, because they are like mostly conservative, that misogyny is largely internalized, meaning the fact that like, there isn't really much of like a difference between like how the radical people or how conservative people would actually act in the first place, right? So we have to look at it from the other actors in order to try to bring this change, right? Because no matter how they say like the moderate feminists would actually, you know, succeed in these negotiation process, at the moment in which these men, conservative men, have that power to have like the political power, monetary power, financial power, we say like those people would not listen to those feminist movement trying to say that means these women need rights and you have to compromise some rights in order to give women other rights, right? And we say like it's rather better for the female to actually work in this situation, because you get a spark of that discussion, right? Because if you're not that conservative as the opening government said, it's not like, you know, you're trying to see them as different, but you have like some kind of, you know, internal recognition within you that sparks the controversy that has happened in front of you. And these can only be happening by like the radical measures, right? Because moderate measures, you're not really gonna feel anything. But at that point in which women actually have these helpless breasts, we say like that is the moment when people realize that the situation is severe for these women, right? And even if this fails, even if this leads to like the aggravation of these women, the uniqueness of female movement is that it's internationally spotlighted, right? It's different from like a no-name feminist living in like Ukraine
live in like, you know, conservative areas, people do pay attention. BBC, CNN already picks up on these feminist movements. We feel like that's the uniqueness that feminism has. That means that the attention would be achieved, and international community can take measures to actually get sponsors, get financial budget, or even have like pressurize those country and say that these social activists are not like these social situation is not good, right? But they can actually condemn, right? We see on the comparison, we can bring better changes, we can bring better possibility of changes, right? And like, why as feminists we have to support this? Because feminists is all about trying to change the situation of women, right? It's about like changing from housewives to CEO women, right? This is one of the effective ways to actually internationalize spotlight and bring that change from outside sources. We say it's going to be better. So that means that even if this aggravates the situation in the short term, we say in the long term we can promote better changes. Yes.
So you aren't supporting feminism directly, you are just supporting, for example, internationally recognized feminist movements. Why must we support feminism?
Like, first of all, we're supporting feminism because it's like the most effective movement to actually support the bring the change that feminist spring wants to promote. But like, even if this is not like something the closing government wants from me, my answer, like why, like what, we have to think about like how the women within that conservative area think, right? Because like the closing government in their POI said that we are actually marginalized as religious minorities. But like we said other religious minorities, we said not the case, but even if it's the case, we as feminists are happy to support other feminist movements that support other religious minorities, right? And we say feminist groupings are ultimate always becomes a trade-off, right? Because when progressive feminist movement supports those CEO women, it also is actually it leads to degrading those women who want to work as housewives. And when the Muslim feminists try to prioritize those Muslim women, it means that sometimes it's degrading the Christian feminist movement, right? And like feminist women, in order to be effective, it has to take one single stance on who, like on which part of women they are they trying to protect. And for these women, it's about like, you know, trying to protect the women in misogynistic society. But like, how about the female hero, right? Because like, you know, taking off your top, like your shirt and being topless and those kind of practices is a hard decision to make for women, right? Because it involves like embarrassment, it involves like, you know, you do understand that you are actually going to get aggravation or like, you know, even discrimination. But you've made that choice, right? We say like when women make that choice, we say as feminists, it's something that women, as feminists, it's something that they must support. Because like my partner has told you, in that context, women would feel excluded like from the internet, from like the society, right? When female, like when what they're doing so hard to change the situation, it's not going to be neglected, excluded by the feminist movement, who's advocates and say that they're the ones who are actually trying to protect women, right? Like those women in the situation have to take off their shirt because in order to change the situation, they have to take to that measure, right? In those situations, we say, like when women make that choice and try to change the situation, we say like as feminists, it's something that they have to celebrate because it's about trying to bring changes, right? And like even for those women who are not part of the feminist organization, like those women are waiting for that movement to actually change the situation, right? Because the they believe that women can actually make that choice. As feminists, we say like those women who are actually not silent but actually waiting for that change is someone who is also most vulnerable, right? At the point in which feminists condemn these movements, condemn these activities from happening, we say that is like, that is when that action movement becomes like meaningless for them. When that movement becomes like, you know, something that they feel offended that condemning, right? We say in these situations, like one, when they can actually bring better changes on the opposition side, and two, when like the support of the feminists is actually necessary for like not having mental damage, we say like we're happy to take this opposition.
Panel, this debate is not about how feminist movement should go about change, but whether or not feminine as an ideology, feminine as a movement, aligned with what the feminist movement believes in and what they are doing aligned with the feminist movement are standing for. We say that first of all, the way that feminists structure with the man on the top is structurally something that the feminist movement should oppose. But furthermore, even if the man was not on the top, we believe that the feminist movement, feminists going about their problems, how they're going about these issues, should be is not right. So we are happy to oppose. We're going to talk about two main extensions, kind of from closing on that. First of all, we're going to talk about the structure of feminism and how it goes against the ideals of what the feminist movement should stand for, no matter what. Secondly, we're going to talk about how exactly this is hurting the feminist movement in these conservative areas. Before that, let's go on to rebuttals to the opening opposition. So first of all, they mainly talk about only one thing, right? They're talking about the fact that, like, you cannot have change in these conservative areas without radical means because of the fact that there's misogynists that already exist. So first off, we concede the fact that there are misogynists that already exist. However, we don't believe that the whole majority of that population is a misogynist, right? So we concede that, yes, so for those misogynists, there's a likelihood that they're not going to change. However, we think there's also a large majority of those conservative populations who are not misogynists, but are rather curious about these kinds of women's issues, or if they're not curious, they're rather ignorant about it. So what happens when those kinds of people are suddenly like exposed to these kind of very radical means is the fact that, yes, we concede they're going to feel something, but what they're going to feel is they're going to feel shocked, they're going to feel disgusted, and that's going to lead them farther and farther away from supporting that feminist movement and having any change of support, any support with those feminist movement within that conservative country. But secondly, the idea of the fact that, like, nothing will change without radical means. We ask why, right? If you look at most Western countries, if you look at other feminist movements who actually have made progress, they have made it through a way that is not too radical. They've had to, like, try and talk to people, have had discourse, have tried to talk with a large majority of people to have them be sympathetic, to have them be understanding. We don't understand why exactly you have to take radical means to get your message across. So let's go on to the extension coming to you from closing opposition. So first of all, how exactly is feminist structured? So feminist is structured with a mastermind on the top of Femin called Viktor Savotsky, I'm sorry if I'm pronouncing that wrong, Savotsky, and he is a person who is saying that he's the brain of that person, but furthermore, he's a person who's saying that he's at the very top of that hierarchy of that feminist ideology, right? So what is Viktor talking about? Two main things, right? First of all, he's saying the fact that he's the brain behind the group, meaning the fact that he is saying that all the success that is behind women, but furthermore, every single success between, like, feminine is all because of him. But furthermore, he's saying the fact that a man should be the one who always guides women, right? We think that systematically that is exactly what the patriarchy is, and through that he is systematically oppressing these women within feminine, right? But secondly, even more, what is Viktor doing exactly, right? So what Viktor is doing is the fact he's intensively instructing feminine women, bullying them verbally into protesting into a certain way, and getting very angry when, for example, things do not go according to plan. So this means the fact that Viktor is the one who is forcing these women to go topless into these streets. Viktor is the one who's making them protest in a certain way and not letting them liberally and freely actually express themselves in some way, right? Now, why is this exact and why is this against what the feminist is, like, standing for, right? For two main points. First of all, no matter what way that the feminist movement is for, we think that they are for the liberation of women. So we believe, kind of from closing government, that it is okay for women to use their body whatever way that they want, as long as it's from their own will, right? However, we don't believe as a feminist that you should have a man ever dictate how you should use your body. You should never have a man say to you that you should go topless to get your message across, that you have to take off your shirt in order for you to have a voice, right? We think that structurally that means that what feminism is doing, how it is being structured, is structurally against what the feminist movement is standing for. But secondly, no matter what wave of the feminist movement you are, they're again tackling the patriarchy, right? So we do support, for example, men, like, cooperating with women, or men even helping women out. However, we don't believe that men should ever be able to stand on top of women, but furthermore, be able to utilize these women to get their own fame, to get their own benefits, and then take credit for every single thing that this woman is doing, right? We think that in that way, what feminist being structured-wise is actually going against what the feminist ideals actually are.
So women want, like, join feminism because they wanted to change the situation, right? Even if that meant that the structure was something bad. Like, why would you have to oppose this situation of, like, women trying to change the situation when they feel that this is being
so? First off, we think that this debate is
isn't about the individual woman, but feminine as a structure and feminine as a movement. Yeah. So we think that you actually kind of didn't support us right now. But furthermore, we're going to talk about even if it wasn't run by Victor, what if, like, what the effect of feminism currently has during war for two main reasons, right? First of all, what feminists are doing in Ukraine right now is the fact that they are targeting religious minorities and so that they are getting further and further marginalized, right? We think that when, for example, feminists go to like a Muslim like church or to like a church that is of a minority, we think that what that leads to is that Muslim church being seen is even more radical as saying being seen as something that is not part of society, right? Now, we think this is exactly against what the feminist movement should stand for, because as a movement, it shouldn't just be about the equalization of women and men, but it's also about the protection of other minorities as well, right? But furthermore, secondly, to engage upon the characteristic about like women opting in, the number one problem currently going on in Ukraine right now and about femin is the idea of the fact that most women actually aren't standing for these women's rights, right? So if, for example, if you look at the info slide, you realize the fact that they are basically tackling anything that goes into their minds. Like, for example, if you ask most of the women in femin, there are actually interviews about this on the internet, you realize that if you ask them, why are you protesting this issue? What does it have to do with women's rights? A lot of the femin supporters can't even answer that question because of the fact that they aren't aware about whether or not this is connected to women's rights at all, right? We think that because of that, the main supporters of what femin is doing is first of all scattered and therefore very purposeless, but secondly, it is making these femin supporters and making the feminist movement seem as though they're getting angry for no reason, but furthermore, they have no purpose whatsoever, right? We think that the feminist movement should, for example, support radical means, but they should never support radical means with no purpose and just for the sake of getting attention. We think that that exactly is what feminism is doing, and that is how it is hurting the feminist movement right now. So in conclusion, first off, structurally how feminist made is by basically the same thing as the patriarchy. We think that it's exactly what feminist movement should go against. But even if it wasn't like a patriarchy, it is marginalizing religious minorities. But furthermore, there is actually no purpose to it, and it's basically just an attention-seeking thing. We're very happy to oppose.
Thank you, members of the group on the side of the group. Next, I'd like to call on the group on the side of the group. Please extend your case for the 7th chair.
Feminism and what are the goals of feminism and how supporting feminine will help them further these goals. So my rebuttal will come back to your speech during my speech. So my first question is, what is the most basic right of a human? And I think the most basic right of a human to create any change in any way is the ability to speak out and to speak your mind and be free to speak your opinion. So what is the most urgent goal for feminists, I think, is to give women a voice, to give women the opportunity to speak out what they're actually feeling and what they're thinking. Because now in the framework we choose with the extremely, like for example, Saudi Arabia, you see that many women there believe their opinion doesn't matter, what they say shouldn't be heard, they cannot disagree with the status quo, so they should never speak out what they're actually thinking or how they're feeling. So we have been talking a lot about feminism, and the question is who should feminism now be winning over in these countries? So I don't believe that we should try to win over the conservatives very much, we should try to win over the men so much. I think first, feminism should focus on winning over the women, because if the women feel they can speak out, that's the first step to change. Because if you can never speak your opinion or say what you think, no one will be able to listen and no one will get an idea of what you are feeling or what you're thinking. So where I'm going with this is that the important thing about femin is that by condemning femin and saying you should not do that in that way, you're actually saying to them, we do not agree with you speaking your voice, because that's the point. Like, femin is just an organization which tries to speak their voice and their opinion, And by saying no, that's not right, or we don't want this, we are actually saying you are not allowed to speak your opinion unless you are agreeing with our opinion. So in that case, you say if you're a woman, you're allowed to speak. We stand for you as a feminist. We want to support you, but only if you share our values. But that's not what feminism, I think. I think feminism should be able to give everybody the chance to speak out, even if they don't agree with their ideas. No, thank you. So same for me. Today the proposition proposed many arguments with whom I strongly disagree. However, the fact that they are free to speak their mind, I agree with. And it's the same for how feminism should view femen. Although they do not agree with what maybe the actions feminist is doing, so maybe they do not agree with showing their breast in a mosque. However, the most important thing for them is that they agree with the fact that women speak their mind and are able to speak their mind in whichever way they want. Because that is the main key issue. Because what will happen if they do not support that? In that case, many women will feel like, I can never, I don't feel maybe free, I don't feel the way that they're feeling. So for example, many of the women who are now living in the in such countries, they might have different opinions or very much moderate opinion than feminists in the Western world have. And if they do not get the feeling that they can speak out their opinion, whatever it is, they will never speak out their opinion. So to come back, about your point. So if we think about the for example, so you spoke about the sway. So people are now like, maybe I'm proposing feminism, maybe I'm not proposing feminism. So people are in between, like the sway, let's say sway voters, swing voters. So in this case, you say, okay, you will scare them away by showing the extreme thing. I think, that is true for them, maybe, but if we're looking at the swing women, which is much more important, I think, these women are now in a state where they think, maybe in the future I might be able to speak my opinion, maybe I can come out for what I think. But if we now say, no, you cannot express your, if we give the signal that women cannot always express their feeling, but can only express their idea and their opinion if they agree with us, in that case, these swing women will fall to the other thing, okay, clear, my feelings and my ideas are not should not be heard because I am not I'm not on the same line as them, and they do not allow for free speech unless they are repeating our values. Your point, yes.
If the feminist movement has to support everything, should the feminist movement also support misogyny and discrimination as well?
Okay. No, they don't support that. They support the fact that someone will say that the woman speaks up and says, maybe I am in favor of that. If she has that opinion, yeah, she should be allowed to speak out, right? Why should she not be allowed to speak out? There are so many people who say crazy things, still we have the freedom of speech. So the problem is gone is that many, many women do not have the freedom of speech, cannot speak out their ideals. Maybe women, even, this is a very extreme case, but maybe if someone agrees with the fact that she is being oppressed, then she should still be able to speak this out, right? But now at this point, women cannot agree or disagree on anything because they feel they cannot even speak their opinion. And I think that is the most important. So feminism should give the view that women should be able to speak their opinion, whatever that opinion is, because the first right for any woman, any human in the world, is to have the freedom of speech, and therefore it can come to change. And of course, feminism can disagree with what is being said, but they do agree with the fact that they can be, that they are able and free to say what they think. So, come back to your second point about Victor, the evil man. So again, in this case, I also feel the same thing. Like even though Victor might be the leader of this of the famine, and maybe that might be a very mean person who forces women into that thing. So again, I think that they can not agree with Victor, and they can think it's not good what they're doing. But the fact that women are sharing their opinion and can speak out their opinion, that is something we found most important. That is a signal feminism should send out, because that is the only way to bring change, to include everyone in your movement. Because, of course, the core of the feminism movement are women. If the women say, I don't feel connected to this organization, then there's no, then the men will never say, oh, okay, yeah, we're going to support this, because they will never support it, because there's not even a core base for it. So all women should feel welcomed in feminism, whatever their opinion is. And I think that is the most important, because the only way for feminism to exist as a whole is if all women can stand behind feminism, whatever their beliefs are, and is feminism is there for all women. So yeah, that's about what I want to say. Thank you very much.
I thank the members from side opposition. Next, I'd like to call upon Prof. Schrickels to summarize and conclude your case for the December next year.
Ladies and gentlemen, we clarify that we do not want to live in a world in which by supporting a radical sect because they proclaim to be feminist, the feminist movement itself has to lose support, has to in turn harm and marginalize other women, and has to go against its fundamental principle, which is opposing patriarchy. We say that by supporting femin, that means that you are mitigating your own power to affect other issues that feminist movement already has power on. We say that it does not have to be in the form of femin in order to get our goals. We say especially at the point in which feminism is currently being criticized for being run by a coercive man and has no consistent goal, we say that is not something that we should support. We say as a feminist movement, we want to support groups that push for women's rights and oppose misogyny and the patriarchy. However, at the point in which feminism itself coerces women through violence and through abuse and also has no concrete goal other than getting attention for the organization itself and not for the causes it is like aiming for, it is legitimate for the feminist movement to oppose it. What the closing opposition said was that we should value everything that feminists say and that we should support them because they should be able to say anything. We agree. We agree if it is in a democratic sense, we say that if it is within their free will, it is something that we support. However, we say that they misunderstand the context of which feminism is happening, right? We say that the feminist movement does not have to support everything, especially when women are being harmed within the process, which is exactly what our extension was. So three main points in this speech today. Firstly, how structurally feminist the patriarchy, which was our main contribution, and how in turn we should oppose that. Second, why feminism is so harmful to the feminist movement and why we should necessarily oppose it. And thirdly, how supporting feminism further marginalizes minorities, which we want to protect. Before that, rebuttals to the opposition bench. First of all, they say that feminism opposes exploitation of women. We completely agree that the feminism movement should oppose these kinds of values. At the point in which feminism itself exploits women, that is something feminists should fundamentally oppose. First of all, it's standing on patriarchal principles, which is one my partner already told you. Second, we agree that women's choices should be valued. We agree on that stance. That is why we oppose feminism, which strips women of their free choice at the point which is a distinction from the opening government that explained why it's bad when women use their body and are extreme, except that we further analyze the point of how feminism works and how women are not necessarily doing it within their free choice. So we say that our distinction from the opening government is that the opening government focused on like the bigoted people within conservative areas that are already opposed to feminism. We were the first ones within this debate to give you substantive analysis on why feminism itself is fundamentally against feminist values, disguised as feminism. And we say that not only does the extremity of feminism harm feminism, which is what the OG said, but rather that feminism itself does not have the burden to incorporate these people so as long as the process itself is misogynistic. We say that the burden of the opposition side is why they have to be radical and attack other women that prefer not to be radical when the concrete harms exist as my partner already extended upon. That is to say, harming minorities through portraying them as extremists that must be combated by extremism, such as like going topless, etc. So, moving on to my substances. First of all, structurally, feminine is the patriarchy. Being coerced by the patriarchy to use their body through being bullied, through being abused, forced out of their free will, framing it as if it is a woman's issue or as if they are fighting for women's rights. We say that, first of all, at the point in which it is used by a man for his own satisfaction, and for his own thing, we say that's fundamentally against feminist principles, and just because they claim to be fighting for feminist reasons, that is not necessarily something that we have to support. We say that women should not be forced to use their bodies for men, we strongly oppose that. Second, the distinction from the clear distinction that we want to make is from people opting into porn, for example, because they want to be porn stars. We say that it's fine if they want to do so. However, we do not want to restrict those kinds of choices, but we say it's not okay if it's forced, if it's not within their free will. And we say that we have to focus on the way that their voices are being shown, right? We want to clarify that we're not opposing women's choice. We are being consistent with the feminist principle that men should not coerce women within the process. We say that our major extension was that opposing government was a versatility aside from the ambiguous harms of moderate versus conservative, etc., which is what the opening and opening side told you. So, second of all, moving on to my second point before that, yes.
So women and females have consent to be in that situation. When feminists value trying to change the exploitation for those women who did not have the consent to be exploited, why should they oppose this quick and effective way to actually change the situation to get the recognition that they want in the society?
Good introduction to my second point, why it's so harmful. We say that we clarify to you that we will support a movement, even if it is radical, as long as they have a concrete purpose and goal that they want to achieve. We want to clarify that what the opening opposition is saying is that it's good if it's effective, but first of all, it's not effective. They're just gaining attention for the movement itself, which isn't really doing anything. They're just like pretending to be a feminist organization, but when instead they're just rallying for not really just like concrete goal. We say this is a response to the offbench, which is concerned about restricting choices. However, the purposes are immensely scattered and inconsistent, as you can tell from looking at the like motion slide, right? The general perception is that feminists just hate men, randomly getting angry at things, not really having a concrete purpose, especially when this organization is getting so much attention from media, from international societies. Furthermore, they're seen as just wanting to flaunt their bodies and not having a concrete goal, and are inconsistent with their values, because a lot of people think that women don't want, like, that feminists are opposed to women using their body for men, but meanwhile, the feminist movement would be seen as supporting this value. That seems very inconsistent to the majority of people who don't understand. We say that this is a response to the offbench at the point in which feminist is already being criticized. We say that when that mitigates your ability to criticize other things, the feminist movement should not support that. Finally, feminist movement and not, it's not just about getting women's rights. It's also about protecting everyone, no matter your race, no matter your religion. We say we want to protect especially vulnerable minorities, i.e. Muslim women, i.e. sexual minorities. But at the point in which feminine attacks these groups just for the sake of getting attention, for just getting like more momentum for their cause, we say by correlating minorities with radical values, like opposing and rioting against religious institutions, you are actively hurting minorities, which is against your whole principle. We say that the majority sees feminine in this sense, especially when people within religions, a lot of times, are actually within their own choice, choosing to wear the burqa because they think it's with their religious principles. We say that we want to protect women's free will. We say by opposing it, we protect the women. We are so proud to propose.
Governments side are claiming their like how their feminism should be, but I want to say at least we have talked about the conservative earlier. Like if the freedom of speech for the women is achieved by the way of their like women, I think we have to call the women as feminism. And whether the women lose supporter from the supporter of female, I believe that is not important. Like even if women lose their support of a female, as long as women proceed their like achievement of their like equality for the women or like freedom of speech, I think it's the way that feminism should be. And we're supporting women. And my previous speaker talked about freedom of speech, and I talked about why the freedom of speech is so important and why freedom of speech is a lie. We can say like, we can call their group as a feminism. So, like before, my moving on my argument, I have some response to the government side. I believe the government side didn't achieve the bottom proof that I believe they should have explained like why female hinders feminism movement. severely. And they're talking about, of course, like backlash, and they talked about maybe discussion happens, but that doesn't change the situation. But I want to say, at least there's a movement which is conducted by the pre-men can like make impact on feeling or like values of the people, because like that is so astonishing in the first place. So I believe in this situation, the people can realize something which people never realize without pre-men. And I believe that in this, like pre-men is so like special, so important. Like we can't ignore this as a feminist movement. And so I believe because the government side didn't explain, as long as their freedom of speech for the women proceed by the act of their feminine, I really government side have to deny this point. Otherwise their women is feminine. So I will move on. And also the other side refers to their claim from opening government. Opening government said, in order to get support from their society for women, sympathy is important, and if that makes antipathy to the people, that is totally unjustifiable. But I want to say, achieving sympathy is totally different from the solution for the problem which a female has. Of course it's important, but I want to say, there's an ignorance for the women. We have to make the majority of people to realize what the women needed. And actually, in this sense, I believe the antipathy is also important. With antipathy, many people respond to those actions which women did. And I think without this, no one will realize what is important for women. So I believe the sympathy and the antipathy, both of them, is important. So I know my arguments. I have only one crash point. Whether pre-men is desirable feminism or not. Okay.
If a movement always has to respect freedom of speech and support people, how will they ever get change and push for their reforms?
I'll explain about it. So I will compare the two types of feminism we have. The first one is moderate feminism, and the second one is kind of ridiculous one, pre-men. On the first one, now currently what is happening in the conservative area is that women are suppressed, they are oppressed by society. They can't even have the way to speak their opinion, because if they can't showing up in the society, if show up, then there will be so severe criticism. So actually, what is happening now is people are ignoring those kind of action, because if people are concerned with those action, they will have a trouble in friendship or family or something like that. So I believe now they're conservative here, these are huge ignorance. But I would say the pre-men is the second type of feminism is only way to attack those kind of ignorance. And the reason is, of course, the female counter the dictatorship where the women are deemed unimportant and less competent and unreliable. And the way women attack this is just astonishing society. And as I said, antipathy is so important in that it attracts attentions of the people. And also, in the conservative area, the army and the police can oppress the women, and they can arrest freely. They have the authority in their society. And or in religious conservative area, where women denied in their name of God. I think in those situations, someone has to make big action. Otherwise, all society, even men, are oppressed by the idea of their religion. Or idea the society has, and in that situation, without huge ridiculous action, no one pay attention to it. And I believe because women had a ridiculous idea of their protest, for example, topless protest, which attracts the attention of people who are not even interested in human rights, or the accusation of the police who arrested the women's member, that we astonish stereotyped people. And in that sense, I believe there at least the people realizing what the site needs. Like people just previously people okay. So then I believe the important point is like through the media or through the, for example Facebook post or something like that, like there will be discussions. And the important point of discussion is that that might lead to the signal of change through the parliament or something like that. I mean, maybe there will be many, in long term, there will be the supporter for the women. And then those kind of people can, like, for example, can be elected and can go to their parliament and like make a policy which beneficial for women. Those kind of things are possible if the internet are filled with the argument which supports women. Or even if that is not supporting women, I believe that is fine because that is making discussion. So I believe this is a story how our parliament will achieve the more equality. And I believe, as I said, there is so this huge necessity of the women. So I believe our parliament is the only parliament who can achieve the equality and the freedom of speech.